What's up, everyone? Lance Hedrick here. Today, we're looking at this funky contraption. All right, so yeah, today we're looking at this Skope Motorizer by MadKat. But before we get into it, really, I would really ask that you would take a second right now, hit the subscribe button, hit the notifications if you're really enjoying my content, hit the like button. All of this really, really helps me. It helps keep my videos not consistent. It helps keep them relevant so that YouTube keeps showing it. It's all to please the algorithm. I know it's really lame when people are asking you, I'm pandering, I get it. But please, if you'll take these 5 seconds to do it, I would be greatly appreciative. And the 5 seconds is up so we can continue on with the video. Thanks very much. So, I know you're looking at this and you're like, well, it makes sense that that would probably be some sort of motor for the Comandante, which you'd be right. This is the Skope by MadKat out of Australia. Now, what they've done is they've created a motor in order to run your Comandante, and only for the Comandante, at a fixed RPM. Now, there are a lot of benefits to this, obviously, which I'll get into in a bit. But first, let's go ahead and break down how this thing is set up. So, first of all, right up here, you have a little bean chute, okay? So that goes right in here where you feed your beans. All right, we'll go ahead and pull that away. Now, on top, you've got your on-off button. Whoop, whoop. Okay, easy enough. And as you see here, we have these lines which you just line up in order to pull off the Comandante. Now, this is where this specific motor sets it apart from any of the other ones you may have seen floating around online. The way that it is connected to the Comandante emulates a hand grip. Okay, so what we have here is I gotta take my little Allen key and I'm gonna unscrew this screw right here in the collar. I'm gonna unscrew it, and I'm gonna show you what it looks like underneath. Underneath it all, you're really lovely. All right, so there we go. So what we have here is a silicon band, all right? Now you're asking yourself, well, why do we have a silicon band? Because this can emulate kind of the feel of a hand grinding the coffee, right? As you're holding it, that's what's giving us the resistance. If you were to just put a motor right on top, you can mess with the torque, you could maybe break something inside. I do want to note right now, I was in an email with Joe McTaggart of Comandante, and he confirms there's no breakage with this, at least not yet in the time that we've had it, and it's because it emulates that kind of hand grinding situation. So anyway, what you do with it is as you're putting this on, which goes on this way, and you kind of grip that silicon and you pull down until it's flush, what's going to happen is if you grind something at too low of an RPM that's really, really dense, denser probably than any coffee, what'll happen is the burrs will lock up and the Comandante will spin instead with that silicon, okay? So they've thought through this. Because if you were to just apply a motor straight, whoops, there goes a little screw for this. But if you applied a motor straight to the axle here, you could mess it up. Instead, this is trying to emulate a hand grip as you're grinding, okay? So, I'm gonna go ahead and show you how you put this back on. You take that silicone, you'd put it halfway through, and then you take this collar, which has these grooves inside, and you would slide the silicone all the way down until it's flush with the table, okay? Now, what will happen is as you get it tight enough and you're pushing it down, the silicon will become will come inside of that groove. It'll hold itself on inside of that groove. Then you're going to take your screw, you're going to put it in, and you'll tighten it just enough so that it will not spin at the finest grind setting. All right. Now, if it's spinning or if it's loose during your grinding, you'll need to tighten it up a bit. But you don't want to tighten it up too much. And the reason is because you want it to spin if those burrs have some, if something's trying to get through the burrs, like if you are unfortunate enough to have a green bean in your bag of coffee, or if there is some sort of screw or something that is in your bag of coffee, which is not common, but it has happened. And if you don't pay attention, if something gets in your grinder, it will lock those burrs, and instead the Comandante itself will spin, saving your grinder. So we get it to where it's tight, but not too tight to where that won't happen. You want to be able to kind of spin, see that? So it has some give. So you're going to take it, you line up the lines like so, and then you just screw it on. Now we have it on. All right, so the max speed of this motor is 184 RPM. Now you may ask, why are you saying max speed? Well, it's because they're coming out with variable RPM. All right. Now it won't look like this. In fact, it will look like this. Those pictures, I may not have pointed at the pictures, but it'll look like that. But this is a prototype they sent me to check out. So this is how it works. You turn this part on, red light comes on, then you turn this on. So as you can see, I've turned on both. So we have it going at the lowest setting. You can see that kind of spinning very slowly. Then as I speed it up, it's faster, faster, faster. And then when I go to top speed, which is roughly 3 revolutions per second, 184 RPM, 3 revolutions per second. All right, let me turn this off. So I know some of you are thinking, well, couldn't that hurt the grinder? Well, no, this actually is in the top rated range of Comandante themselves on their tests, that it will not hurt anything inside. The Comandante is made of really high quality parts that are not going to be hurt by this mechanism. And again, like I said, I was in contact with Joe about it. He actually has one himself. So this machine can go all the way down to 1 revolution per second. This one's a little slower because it's a prototype, but the one they have out now will go down to actually 0.5 RPM per second. But what they've tested and found is at one revolution per second, they can grind pretty much anything at filter coffee without it stalling or anything like that. So what I wanted to do is I wanted to be able to show you this. I think it's really exciting because for a few reasons. One, constant RPM is an important thing for particle size distribution. If you have something that's erratic, you're gonna have difficult to replicate results, if that makes sense. So if you've noticed, you know, when you're grinding on your Comandante and sometimes you get stuck and you have to restart and you're stuck again because some of the beans are a little more dense, what you're gonna have is kind of an erratic, difficult to replicate grind distribution. Now, if you can have something that's constant, that's going to up your distribution. In addition, you don't have to sit there and hand grind, which is an incredible thing. And this also gives you the ability to play with your RPM. Now, there's speculation as to what RPM actually does. You know, you have a lot of these in-game grinders that come with variable RPM, like the EG1 and the P100, etc. So there is something to be said about how this is still speculation, but a lot of people speculate that grinders like the Kinu and like the Easy Presso and like the Comandante give such great distribution, even though they're conical burrs, give such clarity because it produces less fines. Again, I'm using the word speculatively. So what I'm going to do, because you may be asking yourself, well, why do I need this? Why do I need the variable controller if I have the motor itself? I'm going to brew 2 conos, which are 2 conical brews. I'm going to do one at around 1 revolution per second, and I'm going to brew the other at the full speed, 3 revolutions per second. I'm going to grind the same coffee, same grind size, same exact brew. I'm going to hit everything identically, and then I'll taste them blindly, okay? And then we'll be able to see, you know, at least in this one situation, which one taste, if there is a perceptible difference, and if so, which one is which, okay? Now, whenever I brew with this, I use it at around 1 revolution per second, and I've been really enjoying my brews with it, and I brew some pretty light coffees. Today, I'll be brewing a washed Ethiopia from Nomad out of Barcelona. This is a pretty lightly washed coffee, very dense bean, and I'm going to show you as I grind with it. The trick is, you know, you only want to grind a couple of beans at a time. So you sit there and you kind of just dose a couple at a time when you're doing, especially when you're doing the lower RPM. Anyway, let's go ahead and get that experiment set up right now. All right, so I just ground up the first one, but I want to take a quick second to show what I do to ensure all those grounds go through. I got one of these little puffers that, you know, are used, that come in like some camera kits. Just a little puffer. I just shove it on in there. Have it going, give it a few squeezes, and sometimes I'll ramp up the RPM just to help get it all out, just to ensure there's absolutely zero retention. Normally there is, but little hack for you, and we'll finish the brews up now. All right, so I just brewed up those 2 conos. I know this is a one-off thing, but hopefully it'll correlate with what I've been doing at home. But I'm about to blind test these. I'm gonna have my camera guy come on in a second and rearrange them. But so y'all know, this is the decanter that had the slow RPM, the 1 revolution per second. This one had 3 revolutions per second. All right, so roughly 60 RPM, roughly 184 RPM. All right around there, 61-ish or so. Anyway, so I'm gonna pour these out. And I do want to make note that the one that was at 1 revolution per second, it drained about 20 seconds faster doing the same exact brew, and I poured every 45 seconds on the second. So was incredibly precise, every pour was identical, I did the same flow rate, everything to make sure the variables were constant. This one did about 15-20 seconds faster. Of course, this is a one-off, so take that for what it is with a grain of salt. Anyway, I'm gonna step away, or I'm gonna turn around and let Jason come and switch these up. So you also on the camera know, the low RPM, higher RPM. Okay. All right, Jason, this trick me. Mix them up real nice. What I should be expecting is in the, like, based off the speculation, is the lower RPM supposedly should have less fines in it, so should supposedly be less bitter. So I'm gonna look and see which one I think is more bitter. It also ran shorter. So if I can perceive a difference, you know, maybe there is a little something to it. But again, this is a one-off that you're seeing. Anyway, so I'm gonna take my nice little golden spoon and we're gonna see if I can perceive of any significant difference. This is such a good coffee, guys. This is such a good coffee. Right off the bat, this one tastes better. It's actually quite large. I can't say for sure which is which. This one actually tastes like it has a vegetal quality to it, which is not in this coffee. I'll tell you, in these two cups, I'm gonna go ahead and take a sip from both as well before I get a reveal. Yeah, that cup's not very pleasant. This cup's exquisite. Anyway, we'll go ahead and get the reveal. I'm just gonna say one's exquisite, they're very different is what I'm gonna say. And based off of what I would assume, based off speculation, that there are less fine fluctuations in a more unimodal curve with lower RPM, I would assume this one's lower because it does taste on the lower extracted side. This one tastes like a more robust extraction. Again, I could have gone finer, and supposedly, if this is correct, supposedly, I'd be able to go even finer with this one at a lower RPM producing less fines. Anyway, we'll see which one's which. Is this slow or fast?
Fast.
This one's fast. Weird. The slow one tasted a lot better. Like a lot, it was very good. It tasted like a much more even distributed coffee. So I'm curious why this one tastes kind of vegetal, which is normally a sign of under extraction. Yeah, this one does not taste good. I'm wondering if, I have more. I'm wondering if you can taste a difference.
Oh, probably not.
I'm about to wash these and I have some more left and I'm gonna do it on him because the taste to me is pretty massive. So here we go. And all right, so we got Jason here. Jason is a coffee enthusiast. He is not a professional by any means, but he films me all the time, so he has a lot of vocabulary. So right now, I'm gonna have him turn around though. Of course, I always have a second cupping spoon with me, but I'm gonna swap these up. If you recall, this is the one I'm out of breath because I just ran to grab my second cupping spoon. But, this is the one that was fast RPM. This was low RPM, all right? So I'm gonna switch them up. Hopefully, he'll be able to tell the difference as well to demonstrate how apparent it is. And this is one take. Whatever happens, happens. Okay, so fast, slow. All right.
Ready?
I'm ready. You tell me which one tastes like what, or if there's one you prefer. How about that? We'll make it easy on you.
Interesting.
You can take your time. You can sip from the bowl. We're in no rush. This was impulsive, by the way. I had no idea I was going to ask him to do this. What you saw a second ago was genuine. I was just like, I wonder if he can taste the difference. It tastes pretty big to me. Granted, I've been drinking this coffee almost daily for 2 weeks, so.
Man, that's a tough. It's hard. I think this one.
Tastes better or worse?
Is better to me.
That's the low. That's low RPM. So,
Lower is better in this case.
In this case, it is.
For us.
There's no scientific. Thank you, Jason. There's no scientific certainty to this from this video. But you just had two very different people taste and choose the one with the lower RPM as the superior one. So, anyway, the only reason I did this is because I'm sure a lot of you are going to wonder. This looks cool. I want the motor, but why should I spend the extra money to get the variable RPM add-on? Well, I can't tell you to do that, whether or not you should. What I can tell you is at home, this completely aligns with all the testing I've done, which is I've by and far have preferred, I kept trying to say referred, I have preferred the lower RPM grounds, okay? They've been tasting a lot better. Yeah, in this case, I can't explain why that tasted vegetal on the higher one, but it did not taste very good at all. The lower was supreme. So anyway, I need to get this out of the way. I was sent this for free, so know that. If you watch my videos, though, I try not to let that bias me as much as possible, but this is not cheap. Let's go ahead and go over the cost of it. In Australian dollars, the motor itself is $399. And the add-on is $99, which is about $280 in the US dollars for the motor and $70 for the add-on. So it's quite a bit. You are going to be doubling the cost of your Comandante by getting the motor and then some with the variable RPM. So if you're asking me, is this worth it? It's a difficult question to answer because it's all relative to what's your budget and how much you like your Comandante C40 if you have one. Do I recommend it? I don't know. It's difficult to say. I personally love having it. Now, would I shell out, you know, what is it altogether, $350 US for this setup? You know, maybe, and I'm saying this truthfully, and the reason I say this truthfully is because I was about to buy, prior to getting this, I was about to buy another one that I had found online for $230. So and the only reason I didn't pull the trigger is they, that company went out of business, had needed a big order in order to justify making more, and I couldn't make more than one, or order more than one. So the answer is maybe. I'm not sure. At this point, with the amount of grinders I have, probably not. Now, if I only had my Comandante and I love the cut profile, which I do, and you know, it's a grinder that's used consistently at the World Brewers Cup Championship. Alika, my coworker and the United States champion this year, got third in the worlds using a Comandante. It's a great grinder. You know, if you love your Comandante, you love the profiles it have, and you are tired of hand grinding, it might be worth it to you. It is expensive, though. Don't get me wrong. I'm not sure what it is that is so expensive. Maybe there's components in this motor that are just a heavy price for them, but it is an expensive grinder or an expensive motor, and it's a big investment. So it's one of those things where you got to really love your Comandante in order to make that investment. But if it means anything, I prefer the cups from this than when I hand grind, and I do suspect some of that is from the difficulty in hand grinding, and I've done some blind tests at home with my wife swapping cups. I do a lot of blind testing. I have cupping bowls everywhere in my kitchen. But so I hope that this was helpful. Again, I can't tell you whether or not it's worth it because it's such a relative and difficult question to ask. It's based off of your budget, your income, what you value, what you don't value, whether or not you love the profile enough to justify doubling its cost in order to make it an electric grinder, because that's effectively what you're doing. You're creating a hand grinder and making an electric grinder. So, you know, what I would recommend is if you are someone who has this hand grinder and you're wanting an electric grinder that grinds for filter coffee, if you're not wanting to go to the flat burr world, which I would recommend personally, I really love, and I'll do a video on it soon, but my fellow ode with SSP burrs, if you're not wanting to go in the flat burr world, there isn't, in my opinion, there isn't a better conical grinder than the big three hand grinders of Kinu, Easypresso, and Comandante. So if you're wanting electrical and you want to maintain that conical type of profile, even though I think this is a much cleaner iteration of that conical profile, I would recommend doing this, yes. Outside of that, it really comes down to you and what you, you know, value and what your budget is. I want to thank MadKat for sending me this to check out. They're releasing it within the week, I believe, from this video. So check that out. I'll have a link below where you can see that. Yeah, I hope that this video was helpful. If you have any questions, please drop it below. I've had this thing for 2.5-3 months now. Had to try to keep it a secret, but I'm happy to answer questions that I have found or discovered during my time with it. It makes grinding espresso a lot easier too, by the way, especially if you put the red clicks on. Anyway, thanks for watching. I appreciate you so much. Again, like, subscribe, do all that good stuff. And check out my Patreon if you have a second. Appreciate you, and cheers.